Scorching temperatures have plagued San Diegans for the past 2 weeks. While there's a brief break in store, expect the heat to make a comeback by week's end. Record hot weather has left many wondering whether Mother Nature's warning signs about climate change are getting more profound. Joining me are meteorologist Alex Tardy of the National Weather Service and Daniel Cayan, who is a research meteorologist for the Scripps Institution of Oceanography. Alex, last month was the hottest month on record in the United States. How hot did it get? And did that record actually hold true for San Diego?
Yeah, it was an incredible month. The month of July, when you look at the whole United States, was the hottest we've seen since the 30s. And to compound that, we're seeing the worst drought across the United States since the 50s. So the two kind of go hand in hand. And for us in San Diego, we've been spared by some of this extreme heat until recently. July did not turn out to be a record hot month for really anywhere in Southwest California. August, though, is on pace, especially for our deserts like Palm Springs, to break some records. And here in San Diego, we're running a degree or two above normal, and I'm sure most people have noticed it, or they will notice it when they get their AC bill.
And what is the forecast for the rest of the summer?
Forecast for the rest of the summer is we're probably going to deal, at least for the next week, with another heat wave building this weekend. We'll have a little bit of relief this week. When we get into September time frame, probably one more good heat wave, not as severe as August, we'll hold our breath that we don't have a lot of wind during our normal fire weather season.
Dan, a lot of us seem to think of climate change as an event in the future, but we're seeing droughts with more frequency. We're seeing heat waves with more frequency. Are the two linked? Are we now experiencing climate change?
Well, we undoubtedly are. The change in the atmosphere, greenhouse gas concentrations have increased markedly from pre-industrial levels. But we're still in the early phase of the climate change phenomena, and in particular, this event that has set upon us the last week or so, it is certainly not the only one we've ever seen, as Alex can testify, and we've seen in 2006, for example, we had a remarkable heat wave here in California. But it's likely that climate warming from greenhouse gases is playing an incremental role.
But is it happening faster than we thought?
Well, I would say that this is probably on par with what climate models are projecting. Now, there's a number of climate models. We look at an international suite of models these days, and we look at them under a variety of scenarios. But they are projecting, on average, temperatures to increase by at least 2 degrees Fahrenheit by the middle part of the century, and as high as 5 degrees Fahrenheit. That's for an annual average. If you compound that with one of these heat waves that Alex just described, of course, that's going to make things more intense, probably more durable, longer lasting. So it's likely that what we're seeing is the progression of events to essentially a climate that we have not experienced in our historical past.
So that means we'll see more frequency of these heat waves and of droughts. What about in the short term, what's coming up this winter? Where do things stand with La Nina or El Nino, I should say?
Yeah, either one of those. It looks like the current projections are going to put us into an El Nino for this winter, late fall and this winter. And what does that mean? Well, we'll probably have a higher probability of at least normal precipitation for Southwest California. If the El Nino becomes a little bit stronger, then we have a better chance of seeing above normal precipitation. And that's a good thing, because right now we're doing fine because of a wet 2010-2011. Our reservoir supply is high, but another year of dry like we saw this past winter would complicate things significantly. So at least normal precipitation is what we're thinking now, and high confidence we're going into an El Nino. El Nino is the warming of the Pacific Ocean in the equatorial region.
Dan, in about 10 seconds, how would you characterize leadership, political leadership, on this subject of climate change?
I would say we have a ways to go in terms of showing leadership and building our way out of this situation.
Dan, Alex, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.